minute four left in the second quarter. Well, there's no denying that Vucevic's offensive output really makes him a great example of a modern big.
Yeah, his abilities at long range definitely help stretch the floor. But he can also be an old-school menace down low, gobbling up rebounds and owning the paint.
And let's send it over to Allie LaForce.
Thanks, B.A. Well, the Warriors have had a big problem committing fouls. Coach Steve Kerr has drilled them on moving their feet, not getting baited into the cheap ones. He said, quote, "We talk about it every day." And Stephen Curry said, quote, "It's on all of us to hold each other accountable, being in the right position."
Yep, and that's why he is who he is. Good stuff, Allie. Here's Curry. Shoots from the line. And he gets the friendly roll as that one goes.
It's been a clinical performance. He's played a huge role and has them in position to grab the double.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. White, good.
No easy way to stop White on the drive. He's got speed and agility on his side.
And here's Curry for three. Another three for Golden State.
This big night continues. He is fueling this lead.
Back to Caruso. Over Payton. And too long on the shot. Stephen Curry getting it done for the Golden State Warriors. An insane quarter. No one could stop him. Back after this. And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the rout that it's threatening to be. Time called here. The Warriors decide to talk it over.
Fans, the loudest section gets free t-shirts. Is it you? Let me hear it.
Golden State calls timeout. Ladies and gentlemen, your Warriors dance team.
Golden State calls timeout.
Adjustments are a part of every game and every quarter of a game. I think Coach sees something here.
Yeah, I like the chess match that's going on here. Each team trying to find and exploit the favorable matchup on the floor.
All right, fans, get on your feet. Make some noise for a free
Ladies and gentlemen, your Warriors dance team.
Here's Caruso. Let's go with a three. Fires in the triple. Caruso's got 8 points.
That's a move you won't see many guys make. Impressive stuff.
And here's Curry for three. Knocks it down from distance.
This defense just can't stay connected to shooters. And looking at the career of Curry, his legacy is set. The titles, records, numbers all cemented him as a legend.
Pass to Green. And here is Thompson. He's covered by Levine. The kick out, Curry. Five to shoot. 16 feet out. And he connects with a jumper. Curry's got 46. At times, some have doubted Curry's legacy. Hard to make a case against him, though, in my opinion.
I agree, B.A. He has produced in every capacity. It's just a matter of how great he is. One of the top three point guards of all time.
Here's DeRozan. The kick out to White. Drains the triple. He's got five.
But this is how White is built. I mean, we'll probably always see him take around half his shots.
Excellent execution coming out of the break. They've taken three shots and made three shots.
Caruso misses. They put together a solid lead.
And it doesn't seem like they're going to back off.
And the Warriors with another three.
When you let a team knock down that many threes, you know you're likely to be on the wrong side of a run.
Here's Caruso. And the Bulls get it back. Outside Levine. Parries it from three. Levine's got seven.
You see the screen and roll plenty in today's game. Levine, he's so solid at using it to his advantage.
The three from Curry. Connects from downtown. And the Warriors lead by 17.
Backing up that last three with another three. The defense has to stop giving them so many clean looks.
Timeout called here. Chicago decides to talk it over. Man, it's been quite a game for Stephen Curry.
They got to start guarding him out to about 28 feet because he's killing from long range.
A little under 2.5 minutes gone by in the third quarter. Pass to White. There's the drive. Goes up and lays it in nice and easy. White's got 5 points in the quarter.
There's a certain level of fearlessness we see from White, not fazed by that contact on the shot.
Curry drives in, uses the glass to finish the layup.
He's pulling out all the tricks this quarter. They can't figure out how to stop him.
Here's DeRozan. He's got 13.
2 minutes remaining in the third. 2 minutes.
To the paint. And the power finish by Vucevic.
Just an intelligent play by DeRozan. Takes full advantage of the open gap in the defense. Not exactly what coach wanted coming up the floor, but he'll take it.
And there's the whistle. They'll pin that one on Nikola Vucevic. That'll be a second foul of the game. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. And here's Curry for three. Gets the three to fall. Curry's got 60.
As the deep shots continue to fall, you can sense the frustration growing among these defenders.
Levine gets the bucket.
Solid at realizing when to take these shots. Levine's eyes light up. His passes are coming his way.
Releases. And there's another one for the Warriors.
And just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
Oh, yeah, that's what you love about him. He shows no mercy, even with a comfortable move.
Stolen by Wiggins. From deep three-point range. Shot is good by Curry. And the Warriors lead by 18.
Oh, my word. This is a shooting exhibition. A three-point barrage for
him. He buries it from three.
It's turned into a showdown here. Dueling from distance.
But it's a matter of pride and a matter of each side trying to seize control of this game right now.
Outside Curry. Clock at six. Into the lane. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
He's perfect from the field this quarter. He's giving fits out there.
From deep. And it's DeRozan missing. Outside Curry. He gets it up. Off on that one. And so it's the Golden State Warriors leading by 17 at the end of the period. And they've got a comfortable lead in large part due to their three-point shooting. We're coming right back. Don't go anywhere. And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may already be out of hand. That one drops for him.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
Yeah, they're pouring it on right here, trying to give the opposition no light at the end of the tunnel.
And this is how he shines. He's a big part of their floor spacing.
But when he's hitting from range on a consistent basis, it makes everything easier offensively.
Curry, no good.
And the defense got away with one there. I mean, that's a shot he typically makes.
Pass to Caruso. White with it. Down low. Here's DeRozan. Fires the three. And again, it's Chicago with a three.
A dozen consecutive points off of threes. This defense looks rattled.
A little over a minute of the fourth quarter gone now. The three from Curry. And he can't get that one. Now Chicago takes it the other way. Here's White. Drives to the hoop.
These dunks, I mean, they get you really excited about White. His future is deep for the play.
Outside Curry. Over White. Curry, that's good. Curry's got 4 points in the quarter.
He's doing it all for them tonight. Amazing how many of their points come straight from him.
Pass to DeRozan. Now LaVine. And he makes it on the layup. LaVine's got 14 points now in the second half.
As hot as he's been, it still has to be him who leads the charge and helps turn this game around.
Curry with it. Pass to Green. Six to shoot. To the inside. Shot on the wing. And it's cleared by Vucevic.
You got to move past that one. I mean, they'd want him to take that again.
And you're exactly right. That's the kind of shot you're trying to work for at the offensive.
And by maximizing their potential on every scoring opportunity, they've somehow, some way made this a thrilling finale.
Vucevic with a steal. And now the Bulls in transition. LaVine way outside. Out to the wing.
2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minutes.
Jacks up a three. Caruso misses.
I know he wants to get him back into this, but that's not the way to do it. That means smart shots, not these.
Looney. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
First team foul.
Yeah, Looney really battles for this one. He misses the shot and wins a trip to the line.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws. And it's the Bulls' ball. They're on a 13-4 run. Inside. Outside for LaVine. Back to Vucevic. Three-pointer. Offensive rebound. DeRozan outside. Back to Vucevic. The Bulls need to get off a shot. Thompson with a steal. And here's Curry for three. Hits the trifecta.
They have a relentless mentality, even with the game in total control.
This is no let up. You know, this is the kind of hard-nosed competitiveness that wins games.
Barring a miracle comeback, this one is wrapped up. They were able to control the tempo and flow of the game, and it will end in a victory for the Warriors.
Well, they were focused on being productive at the arc tonight.
And it ended up paying off big time. Just an overwhelming performance.
And one player just stole the show tonight, doing everything for his team. A monster night for Stephen Curry.
Oh, man. Anticipation, instincts, energy, all his tools were on display tonight. He did play some.
Shot is good by Curry.
Stepping up and nailing an important shot to put this away.
That's the dagger. You could tell they wanted that one. I know that's his.
Now here's Vucevic. From 13. Called in by Curry. Thompson outside. From the strike. Misses the shot. And so it's the Warriors taking care of business in this one. Showing that they're the far superior team. They win it going away. Thank you.
In the place they call the United Center in Chicago, the home of the Bull, where today we'll be broadcasting live. Thanks for joining us, everyone. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Along with Steve Smith and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan and our friend on the sideline, Hall of Famer David Aldridge, who we'll be hearing from shortly. So Golden State will get the first possession. Curry with it. Thompson in the corner. Outside for Curry. From beyond the arc and then some.
You must chase Steph off the three-point line or you will pay.
And something we've seen the last few years, boxing ones thrown at Curry, although they've had mixed success.
Here's Caruso. And they come right back with their own three-pointer.
Matching baskets from the perimeter, an earmark of today's game.
Hey, players love competition, and the fans love it as well.
Rocket six.
Stephen Curry
sinks the triple. Curry's got six. And amazing to even consider using a box in one of the NBA, isn't it, Greg? But Curry does that with his offense to the teams that defend him.
Kevin, I agree. And it did work well in the 2019 finals. Curry has started to adjust to that look. Much harder to use when Curry has other options on offense.
Here's Curry. 6 points for him.
Stephen Curry.
Another three for Golden State.
I like the efficiency here. Three out of four shooting, just taking what the defense gives him.
Pass to Caruso. Five on the clock. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. Dosunmu's shot is off. And it's the Warriors' ball. Four-point game. And here is Curry. He's got nine. And he drives in. Uses the glass to finish the layup. He's got 11.
I mean, beautiful execution of the game plan offensively. So far, they are hitting 80% from the field.
Out to DeRozan. Cans the shot from the wing.
And that's when he's at his best. DeRozan, confident and in rhythm with the jumper.
Thompson in the corner. Back to Curry. It's picked off. There's Levine. Good. And it's DeRozan picking up the assists. Levine's got his second basket.
Playing with high energy, outworking the defense up the floor.
And I just love it when the fast break results in a high percentage look. Not always the case these days.
Curry, good. Curry's got 13 points.
Man, he has been locked in this quarter, shouldering the load at the offensive end.
LaVine. And the jam by LaVine.
A high riser. LaVine's won some dunk contests. Zach knows how to put on a show.
On the wing, Thompson. Back to Curry. Six on the shot clock. Drives to the hoop. Up and in on the layup. Here for the Bulls.
The loudest and craziest fans.
It's Vinny all time.
Stephen Curry is efficient on how he uses his dribble. Great composure when pressured in traffic, and sometimes he will show off those skills.
.106 left in the first. And there's the bucket from Gosumu.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
And a deep three from Curry. And another three for Golden State.
Defensively, they've had no answer for him this period. And he continues to stay aggressive.
It's stolen by Green. Pass to Looney. From deep. Curry can't get it to go. Bulls trailed by five. 7 second difference, shot and game clock. The tray. In it goes for the eighth time in 10 tries.
For three.
We're talking about Stephen
to play in the first quarter. LaVine deciding where to go with it. Here's Vucevic. That's good. And it's LaVine with the assist.
Up in his playmaking skills. When LaVine notices an open teammate, he whips the pass over.
It's been all about Stephen Curry for the Golden State Warriors. And with his work in that quarter, if you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter in this one. And the Warriors, guys, what jumps out to you in this game, stats-wise?
Just stretching out the floor that first, they had the defense scrambling.
Reason why, excellent spacing. They may not stay this hot all game, but hard to bet against them.
Driving to the basket. He's off on that one. Good D by Thompson. Warriors leading by six. Curry attacking. Vucevic with the block.
Well timed by Vucevic. Not a center who piles up blocks, but this guy picks his spots.
Here's Dosunmu. A three-pointer, no good. And it's Curry with the ball, bringing it up for Golden State. Three-pointer. A three-pointer is right on target. Curry's got the lead up to nine now for the Warriors. Well, see, back in 2002, you led the NBA in three-point shooting at over 47% a game. How would you have liked playing today?
I would have loved it, Kevin. The reason why, I could have shot more threes. And with more threes, gives you more stats. And with more stats, gives you the bag.
Curry looking around. Pass to Wiggins. Here's Curry. 24 points for him. Just four to shoot. With the drive. And that one's in. He's only missed 3 of 13.
Good recognition by Steph Curry. Quick first step. Just an incredible score off the bounce.
Pass to Dosunmu. Here's Vucevic. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. Back to DeRozan. Here's Caruso. Out of bounds. Golden State takes possession.
Warriors ball.
Here's Curry. They lead by their biggest margin of the game. Nine. And there's the drive. Lays it up out of the glass. Curry's got 7 points here in this quarter.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Pass to Vucevic. Outside, Levine. Vucevic trying to get over. And Zach LaVine gets the three.
Love the confidence from Zach at the arc. He doesn't doubt himself for a second.
There's an element to Nikola Vucevic's game that fits well with most of the league's modern offensive scheme.
And with his inside-out game, he's a guy that can stretch the floor. And, Kevin, when you look at today's NBA, nothing is more important than spacing and passing. And when Vucevic is on the court, you can be sure the spacing will be excellent.
And for those of you just joining us in the second quarter, with about 3 minutes gone by, from outside the arc, the Warriors pull it in. They've led by as many as 11 points. Now here's Curry, and he has 28 points for the game. Goes up from the top of the key. Shot clock at 6. Yep, it counts.
Stephen Curry.
Curry's got 30 points.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Here's DeRozan. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2.
That's his first.
And DeRozan, a free agent this past offseason, took his time to find the right fit in terms of who he would sign with, ultimately choosing Chicago in a big victory for the Bulls.
The ninth pick in 2009, DeRozan was part of a great draft class. Griffin, Harden, and Curry all included.
Outside Curry. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and 2 shots coming up. That one on Vucevic.
Very assertive by Steph Curry. Takes the foul and still gets the shot up.
And a moment now to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Warriors.
They didn't need any time to warm up from long range today. Their three-point shooting has been terrific in the first half.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, the league remains in love with three-pointers, but DeMar DeRozan remains true to his game. He says, if I see 100 people walking left, that doesn't mean I'm going to do the same. I see this clear path and want to stay right. Shooting threes, I feel like I'm settling. Whereas I think anytime I drive, I'm going to score or get fouled. Kevin, different strokes for different folks.
Yeah, but DA, I love that strategy. Thanks for that score. Left side, DeRozan. In the corner, it's LaVine. Warriors leading by 12. Thompson outside. Beyond the arc. That shot off. And so it's the Golden State Warriors enjoying a 12-point lead as they talk things over during the break. They've had such great ball movement and shot selection, and it's led to a terrific field goal percentage. Right back after this break.
Timeout for Golden State.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next 2 quarters are any different from the first 2. So far, it has been a runaway. And the Warriors decide to take their first timeout here.
And Kevin, you tend to forget this about LaVine. I mean, he's still so young. You feel like he's been in the league forever.
And here is Dosunmu. Pass to DeRozan. Outside, LaVine.
Warriors foul.
And so they choose to intentionally foul.
Yeah, not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
Team foul.
on some changes here for the Warriors.
Substitution for the Warriors.
Unable to get the ball in bounds. They get called for the five-second violation.
Golden State ball.
Here's Curry. Just five on the clock. Takes the 13-footer. And a little luck that time, but it drops. Curry's got the lead up to 14 now for the Warriors. You know, Greg, I was just thinking about Zach LaVine and his age. He's just now in his mid to late 20s.
Don't mind me.
K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
A look at Lake Eola in the shadow of downtown Orlando. A breathtaking sunset in Central Florida. Welcome everyone to NBA basketball on 2K Sports. In this game, we'll see the Orlando Magic going up against the Washington Wizards. This is Brian Anderson with Clark Kellogg and Grant Hill. Allie LaForce with us on the sidelines. And now the Washington Wizards starters. Kyle Kuzma out there with Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Then there's Raul Neto. Then there's Bradley Beal. And it's Porzingis in at the five, roaming the paint. And for the Magic, Wendell Carter is out there with Mo Bamba. Then it's Suggs. Then there's Wagner, and it's Anthony in at the point. And both of these teams accustomed to winning the battle of the boards. Grant, when you think of ferocious rebounders from your era, who comes to mind?
Oh, wow. I think of Dennis Rodman, Kevin Garnett, Dwight Howard, three of the best all-time rebounders.
And so off the tip, it's Washington. To the inside, Kuzma. That one falls, coming off Beal's feed.
Slick feed by Beal, taking advantage of the hole in the defense to set up a wide-open man.
Pass to Suggs. On the take, banked it in off the glass.
You know, coaches will take possessions like that all day long. Phenomenal use of the screen there.
What I admire about Bradley Beal is the steady growth, not just in his overall game, but how he's embraced becoming a leader. He's someone his teammates really look up to.
Now here's Beal. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
His position might be shooting guard, but Beal has no problems taking it inside.
Pass to Wagner.
2 minutes remaining in the third.
Here's Suggs, pounded by Beal. Back to Wagner. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Boy, Beal's rise continues to impress. Every season, Grant, he improves as a scorer especially.
And the older he gets, the more wisdom he attains. Both on and off the court, his guys expect him to lead the charge. It's something that he takes great pride in.
Here's Neto after the basket by Orlando. Three-pointer, Beal drills it from deep. Beal's got five.
I'll tell you what, I absolutely love watching Beal go to work. He makes good decisions, and that time, no hesitation off the catch.
The three from Suggs, and that one makes him two for two. He's in his rhythm.
And that's how you up the ante. Come right back at him.
A little back and forth from long range. I love it. That's a terrific answer there.
Now here's Beal. 5 points in the game. On the wing, Kuzma. He's checked by Carter. Kuzma, the pass to Porzingis. Three on the clock. Here's Neto. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. Now here's Wagner, defended by Kuzma. Wagner inside. Kuzma on him. And it's Wagner missing. Beal outside. Outside Porzingis. Here's Caldwell Pope. He's guarded by Anthony. Here's Neto. Off the mark there with a three. Here's Wagner. From the elbow. Ooh, he released it in time, but it's off the mark. It's all tied in Orlando. Don't go away. We'll be back with the second quarter in just a moment. And getting it going again here in the second quarter. Fairly close game so far. And for the Magic guys, what jumps out to you stat-wise?
Well, you have to imagine they're feeling pretty confident the way things have gone.
I agree with you. I mean, they hit the ground running, had a strong start to the game that they're hoping they can manage the rest of the way.
So it's Orlando now on the court right now for the Wizards. In it forward, it's Brown Jr. and Achimura. Howell Neto out there with Kispert, and it's Gafford in at the center position.
I'll tell you what, you have to be excited about Jonathan Isaac. Whenever he's on the floor, he makes an impact on both ends of the court.
Avdija, good.
Avdija.
Orlando trailing here. Now Fultz. Pass to Isaac. Ross for three. Avdija pulls it in. You know, the main thing for Jonathan Isaac is his health. Seems like whenever he gets healthy, he ends up getting hurt again. The guy's been through a lot. He's had to battle through a number of injuries.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously frustrating for him, I'm sure. But he's still got youth on his side. So here's hoping he can remain healthy and reach his potential.
2 minutes
and let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Well, Jonathan Isaac making his return from that knee injury he suffered in the bubble. Through the grueling rehab, he kept hope, kept the faith, and kept working to come back strong. He said it revealed another level of grit and grind inside of him. And guys, he's determined to come back better than ever.
Thanks, Allie. So it's Washington now. The Magic making their last shot. Here's Gafford. Shoots over Lopez. And it's Gafford missing.
That's their plan, to get him an opportunity to finish in tight. That's a miss they can live with.
Harris outside. Clock at six. Pulls it from the top of the key. They get it back. Stolen by Gafford. Out on his own on the break. Avdija can't get it to go. Harris outside. And he's in the books. Now one for two.
Harris, a decent ball handler, continues to work at improving that part of his game.
Pass to Kispert. With the drive. Isaac with the steal. 34 seconds left to play in the first half. And here is Ross. Fires for three. That one falls. Nice assist by Fultz. Ross has gotten himself going with a triple, his first basket of the game. Here's Kispert, pounded by Harris. Here's Kispert. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Here's Gafford. And there's two. Work on the glass, paying off that time.
That'll drive your coach crazy, failing to box out. Ugh.
Those are free points you're giving away. You've got to work harder on the glass.
And so a close game as we wrap up the first half of play. It's the Magic. They're up by three. And we'll be right back after halftime for the start of the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, basketball fans. What a pleasure it is to bring you into the 2K studios again. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. It was a closely contested first quarter for Orlando. And in that period, the most they trailed by was three. They were slightly better in the second. Not a big difference between these two teams. And Kenny, what are your thoughts on how Orlando played?
This is what the home fan loves to see. Their squad coming out and putting together strong performance. We'll see a couple individuals stand out. But what really stand out is how hard they work and how they're playing together.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on Washington?
They can't be happy with their defense allowing over 50% shooting. They need to be a lot more aggressive at that end of the floor. Get those hands up, move your feet. Do the Ernie Shuffle. Bop, bop, bop. The Ernie Shuffle. Bop, bop, bop.
Thanks for joining us, folks. We're now just a few minutes away from the start of the third quarter.
Second half of basketball is upon us, and we may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game we've seen so far. And there's a 10-second limit on free throw routines, but We see some players ask for time before they get the ball. Grant, you think that should count as part of their time?
B.A., I don't see why not. I mean, it's about keeping the game moving. So asking the ref to hold the ball longer, not exactly compatible.
We've got Wendell Carter. Suggs is out there with Cole Anthony. Then it's Mo Bamba, and it's Wagner in at the three spot. So that's the lineup on the floor for the Magic. Here's Neto. Pass to Porzingis. Over Anthony. Porzingis misses. Orlando leading. Anthony misses.
I think he'll think twice about attempting that shot next time. The defense was right on top of him there. Really quite cool to see Cole Anthony out there living his NBA dream. And obviously his dad, Greg, a good player in his own day, but also a part of the NBA 2K family, giving you commentary at a high level. But Cole's a tremendous talent himself, the 15 overall pick of the 2020 draft.
Ooh, good finish at the rack off the slick feed.
When it's this close, every bucket matters. You need good looks.
They've been having major problems offensively.
Definitely in a bit of a dry spell.
Here's Porzingis. Rebound by the Magic. Clark, you see any similarities between Cole and his dad, Greg?
I do. There's a toughness, a grittiness to both of them. Clearly, he's a little better athlete, but that typically is a generational thing in most cases. Really solid player, smart, good locker room guy, all attributes that his dad had. But heck, both were top 15 picks. I don't know too many households that can make that claim, so that's pretty impressive at this point.
Time now to hear from our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Last season, after what was dubbed a historic wave of injuries, the Magic decided it was time to hit the reset button, trading away their veterans for picks and for prospects. This will take some patience, but the front office feels this different path affords them more upside to contend moving forward. Guys?
You know, Allie, that's an excellent point, something to keep an eye on. Here's Neto. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Some solid defense from Bamba. Pass to Suggs. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by in the third quarter. Now here's Bamba. Finds the bottom from 13 feet out.
Time and time again, they're creating good looks from close range.
And even under pressure in close, I think they've still done a good job maintaining concentration and converting the opportunities.
Now here's Beal. 5 points in the game. And he drives in, lays it up, and banks it in. Beal's got his third basket on the night right there.
Nimble moves on the drive by Beal. Able to just slip past the defense into a shot.
No good on the shot. And so it's the Orlando Magic closing out this quarter with a 7-point lead. And their defense has stood out, wreaking havoc for the opposition. We'll be right back after this word. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Just a selfless decision from your two guard, showing his ability to get his teammates good looks.
Yeah, and as a two guard, he's typically not a reluctant shooter, so it was really nice to see him orchestrating for a teammate instead.
With three quarters behind us, let's see what this fourth period holds in store. Washington trailing. Fourth quarter on the court for the Wizards. At the four and the five, it's Hachimura and Bryant. Bradley Beal's out there with Kispert, and it's Avdija in at the small forward position. Well, the Magic shooting about 47%, a nice number. Isaac, the pass to Anthony. Unloads from 13. And it's Lopez with the jam.
Oh, nothing soft about that.
Was not going to be denied. Just took the dunk that was right in front of him.
Well, you know, if nobody's going to put a body on him, then that's going to be the result.
The Here's Orlando. They lead by the biggest margin of the game at 9. Isaac. Off target. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. Here's Avdija. And it's flushed down. A nice jam.
The value of good ball movement isn't lost on this squad.
Anthony with it. Beal picks him up. Anthony against Bryant. Anthony, the pass to Lopez. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Hampton into the lane. The layup misses. The Wizards have gotten just one shot to fall out of 3 attempts in the fourth. Pass to Bryant. No good that time. Oh, it's stolen by Achimura. Here's Avdija. Now here's Beal. Launches a 3. Sends it home from 3-point land.
Talk about trusting Beal in the big moments. No matter the stakes, he can find a shot.
Orlando calls timeout. They lead by 4. We've got 108 left in the fourth quarter here. Present our new balance player of the game, Jalen Suggs.
And he's really had a tremendous night from the field. He's shooting at a clip over 50%. I'll tell you what, that's the kind of efficiency that makes a coach rest well at night.
A moment to hear from Allie LaForce.
During that last break, I heard Orlando's coach as he addressed the team. He told them, quote, this next stretch could determine the outcome. We can't afford to make a good play on one end and then a bad play on the other end. We need consistency. And we need to stay focused. Guys, we'll see if they can get it done.
All right, Allie, thanks once again. Here's Suggs. The Magic need to put one up here. Three-pointer, Anthony. Porzingis grabs the board. What a huge trip here.
Absolutely. You can feel the energy in this arena.
Here's Caldwell Pope. He's guarded by Anthony. And now we've got an intentional foul. Let's take another look at the staunch defense during that mobile one block.
Yeah, just some terrific effort there. And you know the whole team will get an energy boost off a block like that one.
Here's Anthony. 6-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. And now they decide to foul intentionally.
Second team foul. At the line for Orlando. At the line for 2.
Good on the first, and that puts him up 5. And he hits both free throws here, and it's a 6-point ball game.
You can't afford to waste any chances at this stage of the game. That means you've got to hit your free throws.
Now a timeout called by Washington. They're down by 6. 29 seconds left in the fourth.
5-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Now a timeout called by Washington. They trail by 6. There's 25 seconds left in the fourth quarter. There's 25 seconds left in the fourth. Here's Neto. And again, Washington, no good. And so they foul intentionally.
His first, third team foul. At the line for Orlando, Jalen Suggs, taking two shots.
Shooting two.
He gets the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And so both free throws good, and it's an 8-point ball game. And short of a miracle, they're walking out of here with a tough loss.
They fought all night, a terrific effort, but they just couldn't make enough big plays.
Here's Hampton. So it's Orlando picking up the win. A clean win, and one where they clearly showed better energy.
Yeah, so true. They put on a show here at home. And I really think they had that extra swagger and confidence, too.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Grant Hill, Clark Kellogg, and Ali LaForce, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching. So long, everybody.
So I just made 60 racks in my sleep.
really want it.
Prada, that's on my shoes, that's on my shirt, that's on my collar. Once I hit her back, cause I'm a baller. I told that bitch to do it, and she said tada. I get a lot of guala, I spend it all on Prada. That's on my shoes, that's on my shirt, that's on my collar. Once I hit her back, cause I'm a baller. I told that bitch to do it, and she said tada. I get a lot of guala, I spend it all on flashy clothes.
2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
The tallest building in the state of Indiana, the Chase Tower. Rising high above our location today at Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports. We've got some NBA action for you coming up. This is Kevin Harlan. We've got Steve Smith and Greg Anthony at the table with me. And the fourth member of our crew, David Aldridge, our sideline reporter. And a look at the starters for the Pistons. Bay and Grant are the forwards. Cunningham is out there with Corey Joseph. And it's Bagley in at center. And for the Pacers, Warren and Turner at the 4 and 5. Halliburton is out there with Brogdon. And it's Hield in at the 3. And tonight, Greg, two teams with a lot of history that know each other very, very well.
And sometimes familiarity breeds contempt. And that goes for the players, coaches, and fans.
And it's the Pistons to start out. Joseph, the pass to Cunningham. And the rebound goes to the Pacers. Hield with it, and he finishes nicely on the layup. Hield's got the game going here with the first basket for the Pacers. And Joseph kicks to Cunningham. Driving in. Makes it off the glass.
Beautiful call that time up the floor. The hard screen frees him up for the bunny.
And Kevin, when we talk about new age bigs in the NBA, one of the first I think of is Miles Turner. Here's a guy who has led the league in blocks, but can also stretch the floor.
Halliburton passes to Warren. Pass to Hield. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And he gets it to go.
A catch and shoot specialist. Hield has a quality jump shot and really makes quick decisions.
In 2018-19, not only did Turner lead the NBA in swats, he also shot almost 40%, Greg, on his threes.
And you go back just like 10 years ago, you'd never think we'd see players with the skill set of Turner. But this is how the game has evolved. And guys like Turner are just so valuable for teams to have.
Got that one up quick.
High offensive IQ. He makes great reads and adjustments on the fly.
Pass to Cunningham. The Pacers have gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. Here's Brogdon. He can't get that one to fall. Some solid defense from Grant. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
And the pass to Bagley. And here's Cunningham. Passes it to Joseph. Bagley trying to free himself up. That's good from Joseph on the assist by Cunningham.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
Turner finds Hield. Back to Turner. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Simply overpowers the defense. Turner's strength is of great value for his team.
Pass to Bay. Grant outside. Back to Bay. Takes a 3. The shot misses. At the end of one, a closely contested game so far. Pacers lead by 3. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number 2. close game underway so far. We'll see if either of these teams can jump out in the second quarter. And when you consider how the Pacers are doing, guys, what do you think?
Well, they've been aggressive from the beginning, particularly on the offensive end.
And that has helped them build an advantage here, playing with good focus and good energy.
And it's McConnell with the ball. He'll bring it up for Indiana. It's a three-point game. We've got T.J. McConnell. And Stevenson is out there with Jackson. And it's Brissett in the power forward. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Pacers.
This is the shot you want to get him. An open look from range.
And A's kick stolen it. Now here's Hayes. To the paint. Here's Stewart. And the dunk by Stewart.
Watching Hayes, he keeps his eyes up, always looking for a better shot, either for himself or his teammates. Talking about Killian Hayes, you see raw potential, a point guard with outstanding size, which makes him an enticing player to watch.
Now, here's Stevenson, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And the foul called on the Detroit Pistons.
Shooting. One thing with Hayes, he's got to work on his shooting. The athleticism is there, but in this league, you got to be able to shoot the rock.
I think it'll come, G.A. I think it'll come in time, as long as he works hard with his coaches, especially from outside the arc.
Free throw good from Lance Stevenson. And Greg, you had a lot of success playing in college and the NBA, but what was the most fun you ever had playing with a team?
Oof. That's a tough call, Kevin. I mean, winning tends to be the most fun, so I'd have to probably say my UNLV team, but we had some great teams with the Knicks, and don't forget about my Blazers. They were also a really competitive team.
And good on the second, so he makes them both. Pistons trail by six. And we're about a minute into the second quarter of play.
2 minutes remaining in the first
quarter. Diallo, the pass to Stewart. Back to Diallo. Six to shoot. Over Stevenson. The Pistons rebound. Stewart. That one doesn't drop.
I'm not sure what happened on that play. May have relaxed a little bit once he got to the rim.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Despite their record, there is optimism around the Detroit Pistons. Killian Hayes said, "We have a fun team. We love seeing each other succeed. We've got a bright future." Coach Dwayne Casey says, if we bring the same type of intensity, toughness each and every night, then good things will happen. Kevin, back to you.
Detroit Tough. Good stuff, D.A., thanks.
He looked just a little out of rhythm. He's still trying to establish consistency from there.
Indiana moving the ball around. Here's Stevenson. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Now here's Jackson. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Joe Linick. Dish now to Hayes. On baseline, Jay. Here's Stewart. And the layup's good off the glass.
Not just selling for something along the perimeter. Excellent job.
Indiana leading by eight. There's 25 seconds left now here in the second.
Yeah, nice silky finish on the alley-oop from the stupendous feed.
That sequence couldn't have been executed any better. Now Hayes. Feet away. That shot off. And so it's Indiana going into the break with a 10-point lead. Their shooting has been the big key. Their percentage from the field so far has been terrific. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much. Coach, it's early in the season, so what can you say about how things are going chemistry-wise so far?
I love our guys. We have a great group of young men that are competing hard, and it feels good because I know our guys are totally engaged and focused and giving us what they have.
Dwayne, thanks a lot. Back to you.
Thank you, David, and we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Good to see you back here on our halftime show. Well, actually, we can't see you, but you can see us, but you get it. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. You're watching the NBA on 2K Sports. For the Pacers, the first quarter was pretty even. And trying as they might, they couldn't push their lead past 4 points. They really poured it on in the second quarter, building the lead to 10 points. What'd you think, Shaq, about Indiana?
Well, they've shown a lot of discipline. It's not about getting the free shot, it's about getting the good shot. And if you want to know how that approach is working, just check out their field goal percentage.
Over to Kenny. What'd you think about Detroit?
Hey, Ernie, it's not hard to see why they're down at this point. They're not even shooting 35% from the field. They've got to come up with some new wrinkles. If they could create better shots, then they have a better chance.
And that should do it. With the second half about to begin, let's send you back to Kevin Harlan. Go back to Kevin Harlan. Go. Go over there.
And if you're just joining us in this one, first half is in the books. One half to go. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for the Indiana Pacers. 10-point lead, this is their biggest. Our second half of basketball and presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. On the floor for Detroit, Cunningham and Bay share the wing duty. Bagley is out there with Grant, and it's Joseph in at the point. Something T.J. Warren has to his credit, Greg, is one of the more storied honors a basketball player can earn. ACC Player of the Year Award.
Yeah, I mean, there are a lot of Hall of Famers who've won that prize. To set yourself apart like Warren did in one of the toughest conferences in college basketball, that just shows the depth of talent this man has always possessed.
Off the inbound pass, and the shot by Warren, no good. Pistons trail by 10. Here's Cunningham, dishes to Bagley, and finished off by Bagley.
That's the kind of toughness Bagley needs to show on every possession. Shake off the contact and finish through.
Let's go down to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Good evening, Kevin. Malcolm Brogdon has become a Pacers stalwart. He said, "I fit the identity of this team as an underdog that overperforms and proves people wrong. It has to be the leader of this team. I lead with my voice and by example. I'll be fearless on the court so that my teammates can follow." Kevin?
I love what he's about, David. Thank you.
He's a real wrecking ball. Inside. Once Bagley has solid position, you almost have to foul.
The Pistons shooting their first free throws. First trip to the line in this one.
And their free throw percentage as a unit last year, 76%, right around the middle of the road.
First free throw is good.
And one of the youngest rookies when he came into the NBA, Bagley reclassified in high school so he could get to college a year early.
And so Bagley nails them both. Pacers leading by 6. Halliburton outside. Pass to Warren. Back to Halliburton. Great pass to set up the lay-in. Halliburton's got his second basket of the night.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists. And when Sacramento took Tyrese Halliburton 12th overall in the 2020 draft, they expected him to contribute right away. And Tyrese delivered, winning NBA Rookie of the Month in his first 2 months in the league. And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
There's 49 seconds left to play here in the third. 5 to shoot. Here's Heald. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. And now a 10-point Indiana lead.
And what focus from Heald there. Not an easy finish, but that guy finds a way.
The pass to Bay. Back to Joseph. To the middle. And it's Grant that time on the assist from Joseph. Grant's got his first basket of the night.
And after an abysmal first half from the field, the shot's now starting to fall.
And here is Warren. Got it up. And the last second attempt does not go in for him.
And we see how seriously Grant takes defense, uses his body so well to create problems.
And so it's Indiana holding on to an 8-point lead heading into the break. They've been playing some ferocious defense. And don't go away. We'll be right back. With 3 quarters behind us, let's see what this fourth period holds in store for us. Pistons trail by 8. Warren and Turner at the 4 and 5. Halliburton is out there with Malcolm Brogdon, and it's Duarte in at small forward. So that's the group out there for Indiana. Now here's Diallo to the right side. Shot clock at 6. Goes straight through the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul. He'll go to the line. TJ Warren picks one up.
And he put on his hard hat on the offensive glass. Jeremy Grant knows where to be in these situations.
The free throw drops for Grant.
You know, entering the league, Jeremy Grant was athletic, had top-notch physical tools, and now he has the skills to go with it.
Now, here's Warren. Inside, here's Turner, and Turner throws it down.
And he can time his passes so perfectly. Wow, what an assist.
Again against Jackson. Here's Grant. That's good, and it's Jackson with the assist that time. Grant's got 5 points now this quarter. Jackson against Halliburton.
2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minutes.
Brogdon outside. Sweet little floater. And the Pacers lead by 7.
And this is how confident Brogdon is in his scoring ability. Able to get it done from everywhere.
Is it to Grant? The rebound by Halliburton. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for the Pacers. Turner, and it's Turner finishing it off.
Hard to stop Turner in close. As soon as he has prime positioning, he is going for the slam.
Pass to Grant. Just over a minute and a half played here in the fourth. Nice D from Warren. Jackson against Halliburton. Turner passes Duarte. Halliburton outside. Indiana needs to get a shot off. Here's Turner. beats the shot clock but can't get it to fall.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Olynyk trying to break loose. Diallo, no good. This game looks like they've got it just about wrapped up.
Yeah, just got to work that clock and take care of the ball.
Brogdon. And he lays it straight in. And now it's an 11-point Pacer lead.
Impressive job by the players, coaches, and don't discount the impact of these fans.
They gave the team tremendous energy tonight. The fans were fantastic. It was a true home court advantage.
2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Back to one. Pass to Brogdon. Plays it up and banks it in. Brogdon's got the lead up to 13 now for the Pacers.
And it's just competing. You know, giving your best when it matters most.
It's called killer instinct. It's one thing to be close at the end. It's another to finish.
So no problem for Indiana as they get the win. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
Yeah, and the first step in becoming a good team is your ability to win at home. And they really seem to revel in that opportunity. And this is what they came out to do.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, TJ. Congrats on the win. You finished strong down the stretch. What was the difference?
Well, we got stops when we needed it. We was able to convert on the offensive end. Just had to make a few adjustments. Able to sustain that and able to come up with a win.
Hell, it was a great performance, man. Thanks for your time. Back to you.
David, thank you as always. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Steve Smith, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. We'll see you next time.